2013 was actually a very good year for Lombok. We had a double-digit increase in arrival, probably one of the best average occupancy for the past couple of years. So we cannot complain about 2013. We had new airlines arrival, which made a lot of difference. Domestic market is still very strong, but unfortunately, domestic market only supply 9 months a year in Indonesia. So we have been looking at the international market very closely for the past couple of years, and we had AirAsia, which is flying now daily from Kuala Lumpur. Tiger Air just started in September as well, flying 3 times a week from Singapore. And the biggest one was Jetstar, who finally made it to Lombok with 4 flights a week. Very good load factor, and that made quite a big difference to international arrival in Lombok. So we're quite happy. Well, we had between 2011 and 2013, for the past 2 years, about an average of 12% increase in occupancy. And the rates have been maintained pretty high compared to other destinations where price war already started. So we are looking at a very good 2014 with potentially new airline arriving and increasing the actual supply from Perth and Singapore and Kuala Lumpur. 2013, we probably look at about 150 additional rooms, and at the moment there is about 600 rooms in the pipeline for the next 18 months. So we are keeping very close watch with the government on this, because we want the volume of arrival and the inventory in rooms to grow in a safe manner for the destination and avoid the oversupply that we're starting to see in some other destinations. That is our main focus, actually, for 2014, onward with the local government to insist on maintaining a luxury destination for Lombok. We've seen a large increase in Bali in 2-star, 1-star, 3-star. We really look at Lombok being a more luxury destination. So 95% of the rooms coming up over the next 18 months are 4-star and 5-stars only. And there's a couple of 7-star projects coming up over the next 3 years that have been officially released. So yeah, we're looking at a more luxury market for Lombok, because I think that's what the destination deserves.
Right.
Lombok has been living in the shadow of Bali for years, so we had originally quite a large inventory in guest house and 2-star lost man, what they call it. But this has changed, and you know, the LCC have been pretty good for us, because they don't only carry people with medium budget. The advantage they have is opening a lot of destination in direct connection. And you know, if you take AirAsia, for example, they have the hot seats. If you take Jetstar, they have the front seats with more space. So you have quite a large price range, even for the LCC flight. So we've seen some people staying in villas and other quality accommodation still flying LCC. 2014 for us, we're looking at, again, trying to reach double figures, around a 10% increase. Jetstar and Tiger Air will more likely allow us to actually reach that target. For us, we're looking at the average occupancy over the destination of Lombok to reach around 72-75%. Because of the increase in flight and the low increase over the next 18 months in inventory, I think it's achievable. And it will be good for the hotel that have been, you know, in Lombok for a while and actually looking at having some great years. Well, we actually are still negotiating with Cathay Pacific, because China is the largest market. You know, the latest figure, we're saying 97 million Chinese went abroad for holidays in 2013. So there is a very large market to be targeting there, and it's probably the fastest market that went from GIT to FIT. So Chinese market is no longer a cheap market. It is a high-end, high-spending market. And we would like to tap in that market, because proximity makes it easier for us. So we're still negotiating with Cathay Pacific. We will more likely start next year with Dragonair, which is their LCC as well. For the rest, we're pushing with Jetstar because we need to have the airlines and the hotel industry working together in order to ensure maximum results. There is the promise for 2014 that they will put an additional flight because the load factor has been so good. So for us, yeah, this is our target for 2014. To wish for more could be dangerous because the inventory in rooms will not follow. And we know that it's very difficult for an airline to add flights, but extremely easy to remove them. So we keep an eye and try to be the guardian of sanity for the island. We've been trying to work on a triathlon. We have the Renjani and there's a couple of mountain races that are going around the world. So we're working on this. Unfortunately, it's very trendy at the moment. So almost every destination is actually trying to do that. I think Lombok is very focused in its product. So we really focus on the nature aspect of the islands, the lack of heavy commercialization. So it really is an Indonesian destination and that people can enjoy from a nature and nature activity point of view. Else tourism is not for Lombok, and that's a reality. But we're trying to bring some of those events, triathlon, but Bali wants a triathlon, Lombok wants a triathlon, everybody wants a triathlon, but we cannot run every day. So let's focus on what we have at the moment and maximize the beauty of the island for the tourists. Diving is one of the largest activities when it comes to sport activities in Lombok. With the development of the west side of the island over the past 15 years, most of the diving is located in that area. And the good thing is that we start to see south, east, south, west development coming up in the future where other great dive sites are located. But divers don't want to travel 2 or 3 hours by car for a dive. So it will take some time to explore those destinations. But some amazing dive sites because they've been protected area for the pearl farming, so no bombing has taken place there for the past 20 years, and some protected mangrove area as well. So we will see new exploration of dive sites, we will see new use of dive sites in the South Seas that have been untouched for 20 years, so it's pretty exciting. Surfing as well is something that people now realize is quite interesting in Lombok. We have some really good waves all year long, some great breaks, and we start more and more to see Japanese, Koreans, Australians, even Americans to come across from Bali to Lombok to find that special wave that, you know, is too busy now in Bali to find. Yeah, we've seen a balance between the domestic market, that was predominant in Lombok, now increasing with the arrival of the Australian. One figure for you that is quite amazing is that if you look at Australian arrival to Bali in 2013, went down 21%. When arrival from the Australian market for Lombok in the last quarter of 2013 increased 175% compared to the previous year. So we're going to see, because of those international arrivals, some changes in the demographic and the markets. And it's quite exciting, but we're still new in international arrivals, so it's going to take a few more months for us to actually see what's happening. But Garuda just increased their flight from Bali to Lombok from two to three flights a day. So what happened with that is that we now have direct connection from the Japanese market, from the Korean market, from the Sydney market and Melbourne. We can fly through Bali and now get a direct connection both ways to Lombok. Whereas in the past with one flight a day, they would have to stay one night in Bali on arrival or one night in Bali on departure in order to connect to their international flight. This now is gone. They can directly connect to Lombok both ways. And this is already creating some differences in the arrival overseas from the Japanese market, again the Australian market and the Korean market. So, you know, let's talk about that in about a year and I'll have some very interesting figures for you with regard to the changes. Well, you know, we used to have a little bit of the Australian market through Bali Now, basically, we got an average of 750 to 850 arrival a week from Perth, when before we had to, you know, pick a little bit out of Bali. So, yeah, the statistic number will be more realistic in 6 months when we combine everything, but it was pretty dramatic. Well, for us, you know, we really need to focus on the market that really now have connectivity to Lombok. So this year, we're still going to focus on the Australian market. We're going to focus on the Korean and the Japanese. WTM in London has been always very good for Europe market to come to Indonesia. But that's going to be our focus, to stay within the places where the connectivity has become easy. You're welcome. My pleasure. Nice to see you again.